What an epic first ever FoodPrints road trip it's been that's taken us to Pampanga, Subic,
sarap.
It's more fantastic. La Union,
masarap siya. Ang galing nila, nakakabili. Ang sarap nito.
Loco Sur, talagang exceptional. Galing. Any Locos Norte,
alam mo yung pag sarap na sarap ka, napapasayaw pa.
Once again, I can't help but marvel at how beautiful this country is and how absolutely delicious our cuisine is. We've made our way back to Manila. This is Kilometer Zero, and this is where we begin our Manila food adventure. Tara! If you ask me, Manila is a world-class dining destination. And you know what? You can find and satisfy all your food cravings if you know where to go. The roof deck at the Bay Leaf is the best place to catch the world-famous Manila sunset. Come for the refreshing cocktails and 360-degree view, but definitely stay for the food. Believe me when I tell you, they serve the most amazing Filipino dishes. Begin with the Bay Leaf Bagnet.
Okay.
This is Jeremy.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Tingnan natin. Okay. Let me try this with the vegetables. Tapos meron tayong konting crispy bagnet. Did you hear that, ano? The crunch. Ooh, look at that. Look at this. Ito yung sinasabi kong Filipino food made very well and presented very well that can compete with any international cuisine out there. Galing na Filipino food natin. Very, very good. Galing. Very good.
I've never been to Bay Leaf and I'm so pleasantly surprised with the quality of the food. It's Filipino food you can be proud of.
Oh my gosh.
Enjoy your meal?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Look at this. This is bulalo. Pero it has a slice of bone marrow on top, yung bone that they cut. I can smell it na eh. Wow! I can smell it. Actually, what it is, it's bulalo with gravy. Different way of presenting it. So, the broth of the bulalo, they've taken it and made it into gravy. Masarap. Sarap. Mmm.
That's good.
My big discovery this afternoon was what is now my favorite kare kare.
Okay.
Sir, by the way, this is your kare kare.
My kare kare. Okay. Yes. Asan yung kanin ko? Okay. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Of course, sir, it's pieces, sir.
Yan, with the bagoong. Mukhang homemade din yung bagoong niya. You know, one thing about this place, I was talking to the chef. And he was saying, of course, he has the traditional part of the kare kare, which is yung oxtail or buntot. And he added beef belly because some people like me, I prefer the lean cut of meat but very melt in your mouth tender. Look at this, oh. Look at the gelatin from the oxtail. As a little bagoong. Mmm. The sauce is thick and sticky. It is so good. Oh my gosh. Grabe to. You can taste the gelatin from the, ano, the oxtail. Ang sarap. Wow. You know, one of the best kare kare I've ever tried, ah. Very, very well presented. Ang ganda. Alam mo? I'm declaring this to be the best kare kare I've ever tried, ever. Sarap.
What more can I say, except that nothing quite hits the spot like Filipino food. Up next, craving Cantonese? Manila's got you covered. Hong Kong cuisine is mentioned, mouths begin to water, and stomachs begin to grumble, mine included. Fortunately for me, Shu in Green Hills satisfies all my cravings. Meet Andrew D., one of the owners of Shu and my good friend. Whenever I'm in Shu, I know I'm in good hands, especially when Andrew does the ordering. So what are we eating today, Andy?
This is the U.S. short ribs, okay? This is stewed and special sauce.
Chinese style, eh, no?
This is the Chinese style. But as you can see, there's a big bone. That is for your dog. Hindi masarap ang meat pag walang taba.
Malungkot man aminin, but that's the truth, di ba? Okay, melt on in your mouth. The sauce is nice and very rich.
Grabe, ang lambot at saka ang sarap.
And that was just the first item on the menu. Now, let me ask you, inan laureate, kasi dishes like these, one by one nilalabas yan, eh?
Yes.
So it's not family style, but you can have this here also.
Yeah.
Now, my question is this, bakit last nilalabas ang rice sa laureate, Andy?
Because the rice is actually just a filler.
So just in case hindi ka busog.
But just in case hindi ka busog, yan ang panghuli.
Okay. Pero do you have customers say, serve me rice?
A lot of them.
Andy is like an encyclopedia of Cantonese food and trivia. And it's always a pleasure to talk to him. You'll surely learn a lot from this episode.
You mentioned na parang you don't just have an ordinary chef to prepare your steamed items. Why is that?
You know, it's very difficult because, first of all, when you talk about live seafood, okay, it costs a lot of money. If the steamer makes a mistake...
The steamer is then the chef.
The chef, okay? The chef who steams it makes a mistake, you lose money, okay?
That's very true. The chef, though, who steamed this did an excellent job. Notice how it is served already, portioned and deboned. Andy calls it chopsticks friendly. Here's a bit of trivia. Andy says, back in the day, the head of the fish was reserved for the emperor and the emperor alone. Eat the head and you could actually get the death sentence. It's that special. No wonder, it's also my favorite part. Now on the next dish, okay Andy, what's next?
Ah, that one is scallops in XO sauce.
Scallops in XO sauce is cooked quickly but surely by a skilled chef in high heat, and the breath of the wok is what gives this dish its distinct aroma. Masarap. Now I know, Andy said rice is served last, but I don't know if abalone rice counts as pampabusog.
The short name is abalone rice, but actually this is rice with chicken in abalone sauce.
Grabe to. Okay. Ito hindi na chopstick ito.
The first time Sandy ate this one, he never forgot about it.
Alam mo ko, Hans, kasi when I taste something really good, ang kulit ko eh. Ano, sarap to. Ganun ako.
Masarap na rin.
Kakainis.
Ilang beses ko kinakain, pero ganun pa rin, masarap pa rin.
Short ribs, steamed fish, scallops, shrimps, abalone. But wait, what's this? Oh my gosh, the main event. Roasted suckling pig already portioned into bite-sized pieces, served with Chinese pancakes and hoisin sauce. What a beauty!
very crispy skin, tender pork. I think they remove the layer of fat also, you know?
Yeah.
May idea ka how old the pig is.
This is only about less than 2 months.
It's not like this is my first time to eat here at Shu. So why am I so amazed? I love how the food here still surprises and delights me. And that's a very good thing. Up next, for late night Middle Eastern cravings, head to Shawarma Snack Center in Malate. Since the 80s, I've been coming to Sala Street in Malate to satisfy my late-night Middle Eastern cravings. Shawarma Snack Center is nothing fancy, but the food is consistent, plus I like the laid-back vibe and friendly service.
So, one thing attractive about this place is that you will see a lot of foreigners or Middle Eastern foreigners here, so you know that place is authentic. In fact, the first thing that I ordered is a yogurt drink. It's a little bit sweet, milky, a little bit salty. It is so good and it's healthy for you, di ba?
When you come here, try to be adventurous and sample something you've never tried before, and I promise you, you'll be rewarded. Tonight, I'm starting my midnight snack with a hot bowl of adas or lentil soup.
I'm told by the manager here, si Chona, is to add some lemon. Yun! Wow. There's a different dimension by adding some drops of lemon. Sarap niya. Very, very good.
What makes the food here so tasty are the variety of spices that go into each dish.
I have two main courses. One is a beef kebab, tapos one of the best biryani rice you will ever find in our country. Yeah. Tapos I like that they have yung charred ano, onions and tomatoes and onions na red onions to, malakas to eh.
The beef is a basic ground beef kebab and I always know what to expect. Flavorful and juicy meat.
The sauce is spicy. This is a little bit sour and salty. Very beautiful blend, especially with the rice. It's loose biryani rice na flavored. Oh, tapos may tomatoes ka.
I'm also having mutton. Mutton is sheep or lamb that is more than a year old.
So what I'm having is called lahem or mutton. So yun, yung ribs niya. Alam mo itong part na ito, it looks kinda ano, parang ano eh. I love this part na may konting laman, na chewy. I love that part, parang may pagka kalyos. Sarap. No, pagka-try pa, no? But boy, this is so good. Tama na. Tiyan na lang.
If you're game for some late-night grocery shopping, check out Ram's Mini Mart next door. It's fully stocked with everything you need to cook for your own Middle Eastern meal. Cheese, spices, dates, olives, lentils, pita bread, frozen meat. This little commissary in Mandaluyong, Arthur and Ara Dancel, former New Yorkers turned entrepreneurs are slowly gaining a following for their Manhattan-inspired tacos. Moving back to Manila some years back, they were inspired to introduce the diverse flavors of the Big Apple to the Manila food scene.
You can go to any block and find a different type of restaurant, different type of ethnic cuisine, just a few blocks away.
So that's authentic and delicious food.
Correct.
That's New York, right? Go ahead. Correct.
So we missed it, and what we wanted to do, since we love tacos, is share our favorite flavors using the Mexican tortilla just as the vehicle to present the food. So we're not traditional Mexican tacos. We're more of an international taco shop.
International flavors representing the tastes of New York, named after iconic neighborhoods. I was introduced to the Harlem, the Fulton, the Elias.
So, what we have here first is what we call the Harlem. It's a U.S. Southern-inspired fried chicken, and it's on a bed of homemade coleslaw, and it's topped with our proprietary green sauce, mm-hmm. and topped with muscovado and crushed peanuts.
Wow, oh my gosh, I want to bite into this already.
Let me tell you, I'm not a fan of fusion, but boy was I glad to meet the Harlem.
I almost ate my glove. Oh, I love this. There's crunch, there's sweetness. Sarap nito. So medyo spicy, tapos cilantro. Oh!
The cut used is the chicken thigh, my favorite. It was perfectly crispy, juicy and spicy, while the coleslaw, cilantro, secret green sauce and peanuts just added layer after layer of taste and texture. Just wow! Let's get to know the Fulton.
So the Fulton is a Cajun-inspired fried fish, mm-hmm. and it's also sitting on the bed of homemade coleslaw, and it's sprinkled with paprika and topped with our proprietary orange sauce.
Instead of using your usual dory, Taco Mata uses a more flavorful tilapia for the Fulton. Wait, let me bite into this. Okay. Sarap ng trabaho ko.
A little sweet. The fish is perfectly cooked. There's a crunch. A little sweetness. I like the taste of the cilantro also. Oh, wow. You know what?
Not a bad gig.
Yeah. I want to hug Arthur. Galing.
Air hug.
Yeah, air hug. Nice. So good.
The green sauce has a little bit of peppers blended into it.
I love it. Perfectly spicy.
But it's not overpowering.
Yeah.
I love my job. Now for the Elias.
This is our Elias. It stands for the Lower East Side of Manhattan. It's Taiwanese inspired, red braised pork belly. You have an extra layer of crunch from the crushed peanuts. Then we top it with muscovado sugar. So you get the sweetness from the molasses. That combination is Indonesian satay inspiration.
Now the pork belly, the most unhealthy, but I'm sure very delicious. You know, I like that. It's extremely soft and sticky. There's a little sweetness, then the crunch from the peanuts. Each one is exceptional. You really have to try this.
Great job, guys. Check them out on Instagram.
Sarap talaga, grabe. Wala matitira sa kanila.
Now, if you're iffy about eating out, the best thing to do is order in. Nakakatuwa how this pandemic has made cooks and bakers of many of us. over the many months of sheltering at home, I've come up with a list of my favorites and I'd like to share them with you. Let's begin with Buto Pao.
Ayan na! Uy, thank you guys! Ito si Melody. Melody is the daughter of Aling Dory, di ba? So yung recipe ng mami mo, hindi mo iniiba?
Ay, hindi po siya. As is siya.
Okay. Opo. I personally guarantee you, this is very, very good.
Puto Pao is a cross between a puto and a siopao. Soft, sweet and savory, it melts in your mouth. Next on my list is of course, ube pandesal. Who hasn't heard of ube pandesal? This particular one by Twinkle Azul is one of the best I've tried. It's light, yet moist, and you can really taste the ube. Their pande coco is great too. Give it a try. Of course, another famous pandemic invention is the sushi bake. Jen Morales makes an incredible one called the Unagi Supreme Sushi Bake, which has layers of ebi, kani, tobiko, tabago, and really good quality unagi. It is delicious. I also discovered two amazing creme brulee cakes. One is an absolutely stunning ube creme brulee cake by Cara Valdez. It's a fluffy ube chiffon cake with lightly sweetened ube cream in the middle layer, topped with homemade custard, dusted with sugar, and torched to finish to give that delectable, crispy, burnt sugar taste. Strawberry Creme Brulee by Janessa Buhayin is as beautiful as it is delectable and delicious. I love how the strawberry gives it a touch of tang, perfect with coffee or tea. For authentic Ilonggo Lumpiang Ubod, it has to be Wawabings. Wawabing is Ofelia Bingbong Araneta Lopez, the mother of Liliana Lopez, who has done us the great favor of sharing her mom's recipes with us. What makes this Lumpiang Ubod so special is that the sauce is inside the roll, and that makes all the difference. Another roll I'm crazy about is the cheese roll from Seventh Heaven. Ivy Allison makes addicting, soft, moist, cheesy rolls that are always wiped out in my house. Now, when you need instant party food with a wow factor, try Betty's Best Sisig Sotangon. This is a husband and wife creation of Dennis Nakpil of Dentious fame and his wife Doris. Betty happens to be their second daughter. I love bacon, and I found my ultimate favorite, Winnie's Deli, owned by Winnie Ayuyao, for me, makes the absolute best bacon. It is not too salty, it has a smoky flavor, and it is so crisp. Winnie also makes great tasting sausages, and her bacon slab is a must, especially for carbonara. Ellie Salar, a very talented award-winning pastry chef we met in our Calgary episode, has opened shop in Manila, and he makes exquisite desserts. Try his classic French entremet cakes and petit gâteau that really bring out his experience and expertise. There are so many more wonderful and delicious creations out there, and I hope to sample more of them, maski masisira na naman ang diet ko. Manila really is a melting pot of cultures and cuisines, and that's what makes it a dynamic and vibrant city that it is. Till we eat again, buy local and support small businesses. This is Sandy Daza. Thanks for watching.